Hi, and welcome to Google Developers Live. I'm Mark McDonald, and I'm with Josh Libney here from the Maps Developer Relations team. Today, we're going to start talking about Google Maps Engine and a couple of new features we've got on the endpoints. Over to you, Josh.
Thanks, Mark. Yeah, so Google Maps Engine, some of you might be familiar, is a kind of easy way to create, share, publish maps, and put data into Google Cloud. So what we're going to cover today are a couple of endpoints that create and upload endpoints to show you how to programmatically get data in. And why don't we start out by looking at a demo?
So this first demo is of a Python sample that's hosted using Google's App Engine. We'll load it up straight away and get straight into it. We start off with looking at some projects that you'll have attached to your account, so you can group your different mapping projects into sort of logical groupings called projects. With this demo, we simply just upload a shapefile. A shapefile is a zip file of a bunch of sort of component files that form some vector data in a table format. We can provide a description and some tags to describe our table if we want to find it later using the APIs. And then we can just go ahead and upload it.
OK, so it turns out this is probably not about kittens. We'll just put state borders, hit upload. And what will happen in the back end here is we're creating a sort of skeleton asset, saying what files are going to be involved in the upload, uploading the individual files, and then getting back a status from Maps Engine, which we can see on the screen.
Once that status is said processed and we're ready to go, we'll get a link showing us on the page, which can send us back to the Maps Engine web interface, where we'll be able to get a preview of the vector data that's been uploaded. As you can see here, there's a couple of little blue outlines which show the data that we did upload. Everything's been successful. So that's all good.
Yeah, and if I go ahead and refresh this page over here, we should see that the processing status is complete. Usually takes a few seconds, gives us some metadata back about the data that we uploaded. So that's the kind of example that you might want to build so that people can use your workflow to get the data in. This code is available on GitHub. You can download it at the link below, fork it, modify it, use it as a starting point for working with App Engine and Oauth and the syntax for uploading data to Maps Engine.
And if you've got any opportunities for improvement that you think we'd like to know about, feel free to send them our way. We love getting pull requests.
Indeed, we do. So let's go ahead and walk through a little bit more detail the code and kind of the flow of getting data in with this second example here, which you can download as part of our Python client library. So if you go and look for the Google API Python client, there's a bunch of samples. And in the samples, there's a Maps Engine sample that we'll walk through. You can just download the zip or clone the project to get this sample.
So on the first run with a sample like this, it walks through an OAuth flow just to find out who you are and make sure you've got permission to access the data. We'll skip straight past that. But before you get started on your own project, even if you're running this sample, you'll need to go ahead and get an API key and set up a project on Google's API console before we'll be able to start this. There's more docs on developers.google.com, or you can ask in the comments.
Excellent. So as part of setting up that developer console project, you'll get an API key. And you can, at that point, download the client secrets, which you can see that I have put into my samples folder here. It's clientsecrets.json. And once I have that in there, I can go ahead and run my sample. And what it will do is create an authorized request to the project's endpoint, get me back a list of projects. I'm going to pick a project here like this one that I have access to, get the ID of the project, and pass that in as an argument, project's argument. Run the script again. And what you can see flying by you on the screen up here is this skeleton asset that we're creating. It's going through and now uploading each file individually down here, and then polling for the processing status to see how that upload is doing.
And that's exactly the same process that we went through in the previous demo, just on the command line.
Right. And now that we have a little 5-second wait here, it would say successfully processed, give us the table ID back. And now why don't we go ahead and take a look at the actual code?
When Josh first ran the program earlier, it was just a list project, which basically just uses this simple get request to this URL you can see below. It's as simple as it looks. It is a get request. We don't need any parameters. We just take the JSON response that comes back from the server, and we log it straight to the output. once we've done that, we want to upload a shapefile. So that was the second run through that Josh did. It takes the upload URL below, which is the slash tables endpoint. And basically, before we can start uploading data, we need to create an empty table asset. So down here, we go through each of the shapefile suffixes that we're going to use, which map to each of the corresponding shape component files that are in the zip file we use, and create an empty metadata structure which describes the table that we're about to start uploading. Once we push this to the server, we get back an ID which corresponds to the table that we're going to use to upload content when we do each of the shapefiles, and also when we go to poll the server later. So then we go straight into the file suffixes and upload them straight to the endpoint we used before, just with a slash files on the end, and push those files straight up to the server. Once that's done, we use the ID we got back from the original request to check on the table status and make sure that everything's all good.
Awesome, thanks for the walkthrough. That looks pretty straightforward. Just to summarize it, we're gonna go ahead and go through the Oauth workflow, which happens like magic in the Python samples for you, but we end up with an authorized HTTP request, and then we go ahead and post a sort of skeleton asset, which says these are the files we're gonna be putting in, these are the different tags, description, and name of the project. And once we post that, we get back an ID. We use that ID to go ahead and push the various files in, poll for the processing status, and we're done. And the cool thing is this works very similarly for images. So for example, if you're uploading a georeferenced image, you can have that PNG, for example, in the sidecar file that has the world extent, and do the exact same pattern. A couple other details, like you might be including some additional things like the date of the image, but generally the same pattern. And then in addition, we have a create endpoint, so you can create an empty vector table without having to have an existing shapefile or a CSV or KML or anything like that, and then just push data into it later using the insert endpoint. So go ahead and check out these code samples.
Yeah, they're available on GitHub, and if you've got any questions about it, you can either ask in the comments or jump on Stack Overflow. There's a big community of users there who are happy to help you out. And good luck. If you have any more questions, I guess, there's documentation we can check out on developers.google.com. But have fun.
Cheers, guys. Until next time.